Alright. Take a quick look at this hand before we get rolling. Hand seems okay. Immediately get paired against Tron again. Okay. Actually, what I probably should have done is just fetched. Possibly we should have fetched a forest and tried to gamble on hitting another land for run in six. That way we potentially could have besieged this Tron land. So. Ren, got that pass. Got a white source. Cast Balky, let's get a clock rolling just in case. Pop the relic, sure. Presume expedition map here. Ursus mine. Okay. Interesting choice. I would lose to Ulamog next turn, so this is continuing this game. Forces in, Brotherhood's in, and we Mord Ego and Maelstrom Pulse in. Those out. All right, I guess I'd like to play first. Keep it mainly off the back of Utopia Sprawl here. Rongren Tron here. Red, just to have things for Brotherhood's End. Sure. Thank you. Yours is mine. Okay. Decisions here. So what green cards do I currently have in my deck? I have Maelstrom Pulse, and then we go ahead and try to high roll dragon here. Mm-hmm. Kind of going down on Ren just because they're so insistent on leaving the relics as a priority for themselves, so. Yeah, this hand just dies to turn one relic, so we can't risk it. This hand does nothing. Keep. Alright, and we managed to beat Tron even without Vindicate in our deck. Last match in this league. Yeah, hand is pretty reasonable overall. Care if this Ren gets countered, because especially since we drew a second one. I feel like we might be up against Goryos. Salty incoming. Could easily basically die next turn, especially if they have a Goryo in hand. Alright, moving on. Alright, four chalices in. Let's take a look at what Goryo is even running. Oh, just so happens that the player we're playing against has recently had a finish with it. Norn's pretty reasonable in this matchup. Hopefully we don't get... Oh, that was kind of dumb, actually. Usually if they're fetching on turn one, it means we're getting Ephemerate Griefed. Yay. Oh, Thoughtseize, sure. Goodbye, Chalice of the Void. What?
Are you recording?
Yes. What do you need? Force of Negation, possibly? Problem is with how we set up our mana, probably should have named another color. I can't actually wish for Elish Norn for two turns. Should we cast it, but I don't know. Not really worth trying to pick apart the mana base at the moment. Mm-hmm. Should have held on to Ronin 6 for when they inevitably had a prismatic ending. It certainly takes their sweet time to make game decisions. Kind of annoying that we're not drawing anything, but like I said, we could have had the Ronin 6 rolling here. Probably could have won with that, so. Thank you. Mistakes keep happening. Part of me wants to go, sorry, I'm just dying of sheer boredom of your slow play over here. Presumably they have a growing husband now. Alright, so back with a quick wrap with our adventure into a competitive league for the first time with this deck. We went 2-3. We went 1-1 against Tron. We beat Izzet Murktide, and we lost to Rakdos Scam and Esper Vengeance. Esper Goryo's Vengeance. The loss of that Renin 6 that I punted and played into my own chalice could probably have lost us that game as long as that game went. There's a chance that we literally could have ultimated that Ren and then just start casting Bring the Light every turn. It's one matchup I haven't gotten a good hang on. I think it's only the second time I played it, and the first time my opponent literally timed out. I don't know what it is with Goryo's players. They are a very methodical bunch, I'll put it that way. Yeah, this deck is not built really to beat that deck specifically. I mean, we have a lot of tools against it. We have the four chalices. We have the four Kaya's Guiles. We could have brought in Unmoored EO potentially. Elish Norn lands. That's usually pretty decent against them. Sure, they have Atraxa and company to go. But, yeah, it was nice to beat Tron. Kind of sucks losing to Rose, but once again, I played in my own chalice a couple times, as my opponent astutely pointed out. And, 2-3. Not super excited, but we definitely made some mistakes in about every match that could have cost us, other than, I think, against Tron and Scam, both on Sunday. We had some struggles as well. This deck certainly has some lines to it, but does also have a lot of error, as we saw in that game. Don't know, like, some people have suggested about adding some of the Surveil lands. The problem is you really want your mana to come into play untapped almost every turn, so I'm not sure, like, where you can afford to add a Surveil land, maybe. Maybe you just run the one of Xander's Lounge and run one of the Surveil lands. That would certainly be a possibility, but, yeah, this deck still seems pretty reasonable overall. We did step up and play some better competition, and despite the 2-3 result, I do think the deck did kind of show itself well, that at least has game in almost every matchup, so. Anyways, if you like more content, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hope to see you for our next video.